Your kids probably have one of these, right? Not quite. Hell of a pilot? No. That skill is all AI. It's flying itself. Its processor can react 100 times faster than a human. The stochastic motion is an anti-sniper feature.Just like any mobile device these days, it has cameras and sensors, and just like your phones and social media apps, it does facial recognition. Inside here is 3 grams of shaped explosive. This is how it works. Did you see that?That little bang is enough to penetrate the skull and destroy the contents. They used to say guns don't kill people, people do. Well, people don't. They get emotional, disobey orders, aim high. Let's watch the weapons make the decisions. Now, trust me, these were all bad guys.Now that is an airstrike of surgical precision. It's one of a range of products. Trained as a team, they can penetrate buildings, cars, trains, evade people, bullets, pretty much any countermeasure. They cannot be stopped.
当微型无人机被恐怖分子滥用，这个世界会变成什么样子？在2017年的联合国特定常规武器公约会议上，有人用这段影片陈述他们的担忧。
The nation is still recovering from yesterday's incident, which officials are describing as some kind of automated attack, which killed 11 U.S. senators at the Capitol building.
They flew in from everywhere, but attacked just one side of the aisle. It was chaos. People were screaming.
Dumb weapons drop where you point them. Smart weapons consume data.When you can find your enemy using data, even by a hashtag, you can target an evil ideology right where it starts.
或许我们不能再说这只是杞人忧天。目前全球已有40个国家正在研发自动化武器技术，也就是俗称的杀人机器人。这种机器人投入战场使用，可以降低士兵的伤亡率。2001年11月，美国正式启动无人机项目，在战场上应用无人机。光是2011年一年，仅在巴基斯坦，美国就发动了约75次无人机空袭，平民死亡人数为52至152人。在2012年1月至2013年2月间，美军利用无人机向阿富汗发动的空袭中，造成了超过200人死亡。目前美军有12000台地面监控机器人跟拆弹机器人，10000多架无人机，这些机器都可被轻易改装控制杀人。除了军方，美国警方也仰赖这股力量。根据美国巴德学院2015年公布的报告，约有200家美国执法机构配备了至少1台炸弹机器人，他们常用于排除炸弹、递送工具等。
With 5 officers dead, 14 people injured, and unable to get a clean shot, Dallas police turned to overseas battlefield tactics to take out the gunman, using a robot to deliver, then detonate an explosive.
Other options would have exposed our officers to grave danger.
In recent years, SWAT teams have come to rely on robots, sent in with cameras to locate a gunman, to inspect suspicious bags, even detonate explosives. Now, for the first time, delivering and detonating a bomb.
2016年发生在达拉斯的袭警案爆发出的机器人杀人事件，是机器人被操纵杀人，首次从战场进入公众视线。尽管这并非机器人的自主杀人，却仍引发法律争议跟伦理担忧，甚至对机器的恐慌。
This short film is more than just speculation. It shows the results of integrating and miniaturizing technologies that we already have. I'm Stuart Russell, a professor of computer science at Berkeley. I've worked in AI for more than 35 years. Its potential to benefit humanity is enormous, even in defense. But allowing machines to choose to kill humans will be devastating to our security and freedom. Thousands of my fellow researchers agree. We have an opportunity to prevent the future you just saw, but the window to act is closing fast.
2013年，联合国人权委员会对杀人机器人下了定义，在无外界人为信息输入的条件下，能够对目标发动袭击的机器人。因此，包括知名物理学家霍金、特斯拉执行长穆斯克在内的100多名企业家，都呼吁各国冻结或停止研发杀人机器人，并且诉请联合国将此列入特定常规武器公约的禁止名单。